We're here with Lando Marin, the last Mambo King. When you mentioned that on the stage, we're really talking about the time and the época, the era of Tolo Mambero, all the Mambo Knicks that went to the Palladium. Of course, you were one of the individuals. You also mentioned something about Eddie Palmieri playing in the band. Wasn't there Joe Quijano and a few other people that were in that band when it first started?
I started my band when I was living on Dawson Street and Longwood Avenue. Eddie Palmieri lived on Kelly Street, and so did Joe Quijano. Eventually, I moved to Kelly Street, to Banana Kelly. It's a very famous place now. And Joe was the singer, Eddie was the pianist, and I had a lot of the local people in the band, like Benny Bonilla was a conga player. I had Larry Chino, Larry Acevedo, trumpet, a guy called Claude Esperson, and Louis Robles, I got the name now.
Is it true, correct, as we were talking about, I read somewhere that at a young age, your mother encouraged you to go to vocal lessons and take singing lessons.
Yeah.
You know, but you became an orphan at a young age. Your mother passed away.
Yeah.
You gave up music for quite some time before you got together with the fellas. How did that end up being? How did the music come back into your life in your childhood?
Well, I actually, I'm going to look at the camera, right?
Sure, yeah, you can look right at the camera.
I actually started out at the age of 2 or 3 years old. I was singing in English and Spanish, and I was tap dancing. And I was learning, and I learned how to dance in Spanish. I used to dance the tango also. But when my mother passed away, before she passed away, she sent me to school to get vocal lessons and tap dancing lessons. She passed away when I was 10, so I stopped. But when I was 15, I got into dancing the mambo because it was very big. So eventually, within a year, I got interested in playing drums, the timbales, because I heard the cowbells. And it excited me.
Well, that's another thing. You're self-taught.
We have to tell
the public out there, they can understand that you're a self-taught percussionist. You know, when you play congas and bongo, that's what I'm talking about.
And I sing, which is a little harder, but...
Well, that's an art in itself. You know, timbalero, cantante, and singing, y soñando la misma vez. That's a lost art. Not too many people do that.
Yo soy timbalero mayor.